too much music. We're going to be hooking up with Melanie B of the Spice Girls, who has just released her solo debut entitled Hot. We'll be talking to her about that. But this city's been here long before the Spice Girls, and will be here long after. So let's go see some of it. Now, the Spice Girls originally got together through a series of audition calls. Melanie B did not actually attend the first audition call for the Spice Girls. She was in the same building attending a bunch of other audition calls. However, the Spice Girls came together around late 94, released their first album entitled Spice in 96, and after that, exploded. If you wanna be my lover, you gotta get with my friends. Now, with the Spice Girls on everything from bed sheets to bubblegum, they released their second album entitled Spice World in 1997. Most of that album became the unofficial soundtrack to the theatrical release of the movie of the same name in 1998. Spice Mania was in full effect. Late in the year 2000, 3 years after they released The Spice World, the Spice Girls, well, the remaining Spice Girls following the departure of Jerry Halliwell in mid-98, released their third album entitled Forever. Some panned it because it didn't post as big numbers as the first two albums, but it was still a moneymaker all the same. Part of me likes that, part of me cries, part of me wants to question why. The third of their offspring didn't do as well as the first two, and speaking of offspring, both Melanie B and Victoria went on to have children, and each of the remaining Spice Girls went on to do solo projects, setting up their war chest, because after all, someday, even though the Spice Girls are still together, there will be life after Spice. Melanie B releases Hot. That's the reason we're here. Oh, the Tower Bridge. London town, one of the big musical capitals of all the world, we find ourselves getting prepared for the big interview with Melanie B as she celebrates the release of her solo debut album, Hot. Speaking of hot, I'd recognize that bonbon anywhere. Melanie B, are you excited about your solo release? Doing some vocal warm-ups, I understand, as any good singer should. Now, when you named your first album Hot, what was that all about?
Hot.
So it's because you're... Hey, careful where you put that hand, Melanie B. Those are goods reserved for one special lady. Hey, you brought your friends, all the Spice Girls. Mel, why don't we ditch these ladies and go see some of the sights of London? Oh, you want to make out first? Well, guy's got to do what a guy's got to do. Yeah, we're here at at the Virgin UK offices with Melanie Janine Brown.
Actually, we're in a really cool place. This place is Nancy Barry's office. It's got, it looks a bit like kind of Moroccan. She like runs quite a lot of the Virgin.
Does she entertain in here?
I think she does.
Does she fancy a nice afternoon nap? Because these couches look very comfortable.
Very good. See, people like Rolling Stones and Janet Jackson have sat here. And now us.
And if we didn't have to get on the road, I'd say let's have a nap. But we got places to see.
Yeah, we're going to go to... Do you know... God, I'm burping. Do you know where we're going? We're going to the London Eye, which is the big wheel. And then we're going to go to the aquarium. So we're going to be like kids again. And you're going to come with us.
It will feel so good. Welcome to the aquarium at the bank of the Thames River, Melanie B. Whoa, hey, hey now. She's here to play, she's here to play.
I can see lots of lovely smelling fish. Hi.
Hello?
Who's that?
He could barely contain himself.
Bill.
He was excited.
Oh, look, I have my passports in here. Why do I have my passports?
Let's see the passport picture.
Oh, you'll die.
Melanie B's passport picture in 5, 4, 3. And there, don't see, it's important.
I've got braids in, I look quite horrific.
You look hot. Melanie Brown.
Like,
careful.
They kill me.
We're in the room where the clothes are, the wetsuits.
They look like dead bodies.
From season 3 Soprano finale into the grand aquarium ballroom, Mal after you. You look beautiful.
I have to do my hair ready for the entrance.
You look hot, you look stunning. Here she is.
See, this is more like it.
There we go.
Now we're in the thick of it. There are the sharks there. You're missing the main bit. The sharks there.
Well, why don't we go look at the sharks?
Yeah.
He's myopic. That's
nearsighted. He just bumped into the thingy. Very interesting, isn't it? I've just done a film called Fish.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah. It's only 15 minutes long, but it's not. It's about this guy, my son, who's mixed race, finds it quite difficult to get on with normal people. So he kind of identifies with these tropical fish.
I find it hard to get on with normal people sometimes. Are you excited about it?
Because it feels so good.
Oh, yeah.
I'm excited about the whole album. But this song particularly is very upbeat, very happy. And I did it with Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis, and they're just like legends to work with.
You worked on a few songs with them.
I did two. A really upbeat, fast one and a slow one, and they put all candles around. And I had Janet Jackson's Mike. And I was lying down.
Since we're talking about that song, a young fellow like me, I was fanning myself. Are you talking about Feel Me Now?
Yeah, the semi-rude one.
I was fanning myself. You'll understand when you buy the new CD that it's quite a sensual song. And
no, but you know what I did? I recorded the choruses and the bridges, and then the verses, I just laid there and talked and said whatever came into my head.
Talk about the photography on your album now. How do you feel about that?
Look, all the fish have come round to see what's happening.
Because they've seen the cover of your album.
Is that in a bikini? I was in the desert. I was hot. Come on, let's go touch some fish.
Can we? Let's try and do that.
Boy, I'm tired of you. Running over me, telling me what to do now. What have I done to you? To make you sex a lot, I thought I made you hot. Now don't make me act a fool. I know I talk my junk, but I know what I want. What I truly want is you. And even though you're a Mac, true that I want you back. I think I want you back. Good love is made a deep impact. I know it might sound wise.
Wet your hand first. Okay, you hold my feet. And...
No, this side touches more.
Okay. Be nice. Careful.
You want to touch the fish?
The fish might bite your fingers.
So what did you listen to when you were growing up then?
When I was growing up, I was a big fan of Nina Cherry, Bobby Brown, Tracy Chapman, Whitney Houston, all them kind of people. I was a big Bobby Brown fan, one of those.
New Edition style?
Yes, and they do all that.
That girl is poison.
Humpty Hump.
Yeah,
we're
come
doing
on and do the Humpty Hump.
I was into all that. Look at his performing.
He knows. He knows the spotlight's on him.
There's one there, look. It's just in disguise. Go on, carry on with what you're saying.
He's napping.
He is.
Tell me.
Yeah, that's a bit angry.
Because somebody tried to get with Mel B just for her money. That's
the
thing
people will do.
You got to collaborate with a few people. You got to collaborate with, as far as producers, Teddy Riley did some for you, Rodney Jerkins did some for you.
And Cisco.
Cisco.
And I've done Missy Elliott one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you did some work at Paisley Park when you were...
Yes, but no, I didn't work with him.
No,
I was interviewing him.
But you want him.
I interviewed him for a different show, but if I do a second album, which I will do. I'm going to be working with him and Mary J. Blige.
So you're excited?
That's good, yeah. Can you tell? Hello.
Hello.
Hello. You're on TV in Canada.
My hands smell. Don't put your hands in the water, they'll smell. She's like, so? I want to find the jellyfish thing. Hello. If you want to.
Right now they're taking
a
photo.
There's a block where there's jellyfish in.
We'll have to find it.
We have to ask where it is.
Right now they're taking a photo of international recording artist Mel B.
It's down there, I think. Look!
The incandescent jellyfish.
Oh, half of them have died. I'm sure there was more than this before. Isn't they looking a bit dead?
Well, some of them have went on to the great jellyfish beyond. You know, it's part of life. You've been here before.
I've been here before, yeah. Once before with Phoenix. She was like that. Wow. It's nice.
Does she know that her mother's Mel B?
I think like when she sees me on TV, she's like, Mummy! And she looks at me like if I've done a pre-record. Yeah. She'll look at me on TV and she'll be looking at me there. They'd say, but how can you be on there if you're here? She's like a bit confused. But whenever my music comes on, she's like that. Mummy, and she dances a little.
Does she have a favourite song?
I think she likes all of them. Well, I just stick the CD on and she dances to everything. Look at that.
I don't know if you could touch that one.
Do you know, that's what those wetsuits were for. They stick them on and they dive in. It's nice, it's wet. Do you think it's very calm in here?
It's very calm.
Oh my God.
That's solid.
That nearly came,
that
nearly
That's solid
crashed.
Plastic. That's not going to...
Yeah, but you know what happened when Jaws crashed it? It got through.
Are you going to take Hot on the Road soon? Like
Hopefully,
this year?
Yeah.
When?
Do a few gigs and dates and stuff.
Have you done any of it? Have you performed some of those songs yet?
Yeah, I performed Tell Me and Feel So Good, promoting it on like TVs and stuff like that. But
And they dug it? They ate it up?
Yeah, they were quite...
Buying
yeah.
what you were selling?
Yeah, it's good.
Nice.
It's a good vibe getting up there and doing your own music. A bit lonely sometimes because it's like I'm used to being with the girls, but I have my dancers behind me.
Yeah.
So it's good. You and me, oh, yeah. No one can touch us now. That is how it's got to be.
look.
Did you know the red-bellied piranha is the most dangerous of the 20 Amazonian species?
Really?
It's a fact.
We're gonna feed some fish.
Oh, wait, there are some fish down at the bottom.
They don't know. You know, the girls bought me a fish tank with fish for my 21st birthday. They bought me
what
a fish tank.
What girls are that?
Vicky, Emma, Jerry, and Melanie.
These are friends of yours.
And they got me five fish.
These girls.
All represented us. Isn't that sweet? But then they died. But we all die sooner or later.
Yeah. I have a confession to make.
What's your confession?
When I was... when I was 20...
maybe, yes?
And I was living in Banff, Alberta. It's
yes.
Beautiful. It's in the Rocky Mountains in Canada. I drove an hour and a half to see a movie that you were in.
Uh-huh.
And that movie was called The Spice World.
It's fun, isn't it?
Don't you know? Why can't you see?
Slow it down, read the signs, say you know just where you're going.
Stop right now, thank you very much. I need somebody with a human touch.
It was fun, and I bought it. I ended
on
up buying
DVD or video?
On VHS. Actually, my flatmate bought it for me for my birthday. The one that I went to see this movie with. And I brought it here, but I forgot it at our hotel room.
Ah. Oh, I could have put something on there for you. So you'd remember me.
Yeah. I don't think I'll ever forget you, Mel B.
You won't, because you're going to have a nightmare about the sharks tonight. That's why.
In the whip, but he didn't know I wasn't on that money shit. Bum real tight up top, my thick independent chick. But if you were me,
bye, you're not coming in. Your name's not down on this capsule, so you're not coming in.
They should have called her Cheeky Spice.
British Airways. What do you do? Do you just look at London?
You do indeed. 360 degrees, BT Tower, which is just over there, and that's Russell Square that way. And also Centre Point, which is on the junction of Tottenham Court Road and Oxford Street. This is the Ministry of Defence just behind you, with the four green roofs. And behind that is Buckingham Palace.
I was a Londoner for 2 years, and then I moved out of London.
Where do you live
this
at?
Is all new to me.
And you can
I live out in the country.
Yeah, you know I'm a fool, ooh, I'm a fool for you. Cause I keep taking you back as though I'm stupid like that. Yeah, yeah, you know it's true. But I can't say no, and I never said no.
So you've done all the writing on Hot, and you and the girls were all writing on Forever.
Yeah.
Now, is that a newer thing? I mean, the more you record... Yeah, but you must have increased your writing.
Writing abilities, yeah. Mm-hmm. But we've always written from the first album to the second album, third album, and then our own individual albums.
So, what are you writing about these days? Like with Hot?
It's all quite personal.
Yeah.
As with the Spice album, it's personal, but a bit more genuine.
Was it hard to write so personally?
Well, I've been keeping diaries for so long. I find it really easy to write down what I think and or what I thought about when I met that person or the situation that happened to me. Then I find it easy. I constantly write every day. I know it might sound right, but damn, I think I want you back. We made it to the top, we're halfway there.
You've had audiences with like political leaders like Nelson Mandela, you've met all sorts of people. Who are you most honored to meet? Who are you most...
Well, I haven't met her yet. I want to meet Tina Turner properly. I'd love to meet her. But then again, Nelson Mandela was just unbelievable. I went to his house and we had tea and like met all his family and just chilled with him in his front lounge and it was like amazing. And we also went to his bathroom and pinched loads of his toilet roll. Start with.
Yeah, are you okay with that?
Yeah, not that actually.
I can move away if you want.
Oh, I was thinking the same.
I could.
Let's get really close. Let's do the interview like this. So then, right. Oh, I can see you in there.
How do you like my teeth?
Quite good, actually.
You have fairly good teeth as well.
Thanks. I've never had a filling in my life. That's a fact that I bet you didn't know.
I didn't know that.
No.
Because they don't put that in any of the articles. Now, when you were a kid, before all of this...
Yeah, I still am a kid.
Oh, you're not in public school anymore.
You're
on your own. But when you were a kid, did you suspect that any of this would come to pass? I mean, was this all part of the Melanie B plan?
You know, I wanted to be recognised and heard because I'm quite a loud, opinionated, free-spirited person, but I never think for one minute that I'd be part of something which is so amazing. And at the same time, I have a choice in it and get to do what I want, as in my own music and all that.
Let's go from the very start. When we met, you and I were inseparable. All our months, we swapped our hearts, knowing that we had it right.
You were honored in wax at Madame Tussauds' wax circus.
And that was really weird doing that. Because you know what you had to wear? You had to go in there and wear shorts and a tiny top, and they measure everything, like from there to there, from there to there, like from nipple to nipple, mm-hmm. from hip to hip, everything. So you know all your measurements of your body.
I actually, I stole a kiss from your wax figure.
So it was like that. I chose the hardest position. Like, Emma chose a position like this, I think Melanie chose one like this, and I chose that. And I had to stand there getting measured for about 2 hours at that. And about five different people measuring everything. Damn. Everything will be all right, I promise. We're nearly here.
Well,
we can
Melanie,
breathe now. We're here.
Thanks for taking care of me on this trip. On the London Eye.
And look, you're welcome.
Mel, if you're ever in Toronto, you call me and I'll make you a grilled cheese sandwich.
Okay. Thank you. Oh, you really? Thank you. Well, you squashed me.
Sorry about that. Yeah, thanks.
Thank you,
boy. Well, Mel, I wish to thank you again for the time you've spent showing us around this lovely city of London. Some fans for you, or me, I'm not sure. But I thank you again.
Thank you.
And if you want the grilled cheese sandwich,
no,
you
I
come
do.
To Toronto.
As long as you got, can we not do chicken with melted cheese on
chicken
it?
Chicken and melted cheese, we'll do it all. It's been wonderful.
Perfect.
One more time, I won't Ooh. Squish you.
Squish,
and off you go. Be careful, all the best to you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Come on. See you later, bye.
Bye. Yes.
I thought there was no help for me, 'cause you made me think I wasn't worth anything. Now I see you didn't have no self-esteem, and all you loved was Mel B's.